Yesterday, we have started our third, fourth unit, that is memory management in the operating system, right? So in that we have discussed why we required to manage the memory, number of processes will be there, which will be accessed or which will be kept where, in the secondary memory or in the primary memory or in the registers or in the cache memory, and how we are going to manage that, how many number of processes going to reside in that particular space. That will be depend upon the management of operating system. There are different techniques available by choosing to choose any particular process at particular place. That will be depend upon some techniques. The techniques we are going to learn today. But yesterday we have also discussed about the memory management will be done by two types. That is contiguous, and another method is the non-contiguous method. The contiguous method is what? Whenever your processes will be, we can say, whenever your processes will be residing into your main memory or anywhere in the system, the position of that processes or that will those will be placed continuously in a continuous address location, right? It doesn't happen कि process का एक part इधर है, दूसरा part कहीं और है, या फिर कोई और process भी अगर आती है, there should not happen कि one process is kept somewhere here and another process is kept at the end or at the lower address space. It doesn't happen in the contiguous memory allocation. Contiguous memory allocation is the continuous allocation of the address spaces to the processes. Okay, then we have in this again we have the two types. In two types we can allocate the memory continuously to the processes, that is static and the dynamic. Now what is the difference between both? This is also called as the fixed partitioning, and this is called as the variable partitioning. Now what is happening in this case? Fixed partitioning means whatever your system memory you have, suppose this is a RAM, and if you have this RAM memory, then in the fixed partitioning your entire memory apart from this OS required memory, apart from this, whatever the remaining memory is there, the partitioning will be fixed. It will be divided into the fixed amount of memory. Okay, and whenever the process will come, that process will be placed into this partition itself. So it requires ki process size or the requirement of the process memory should be less than or equal to that partition. We have discussed this yesterday, right? So I was saying about this, if you have a process with equals to or the less than the size of that partition, then only any process can reside into that partition, otherwise you cannot proceed that process. Okay, now after that we will have the second type, which is called as the variable. This is also the type of fixed partition. This is also the type of fixed partition, but in this method the partition size is not fixed. Partitions are fixed, 4 partitions karne hain, 10 partitions karne hain, 12 partitions karne hain, that is the fixed part. Okay, but the size of the partition is not fixed in this diagram. This is the size is not fixed of the partition, and this is the fixed size of partition. Okay, so we have also discussed there are two problems can occur. One is the internal fragmentation and another is the external fragmentation. I also discussed ki this is very important point with respect to your competitive examinations or objective questions, or we can say in the Viva examinations also these questions will be asked: internal fragmentation, external fragmentation. So internal fragmentation is what? Once you allocate any process into this partition, and if any space will be remaining, okay, if any space will remain in this partition, you cannot allocate any other process. Okay, koi dusre process ka requirement hai 5 MB and the available place in this fixed partition if it is 7 MB, but you still cannot allocate that process into this partition and you cannot use that memory, so it is a wastage of space, isn't it? So this is called as the internal fragmentation. Inside of the fragmentation, if there is a wastage of memory space, then it is called as internal fragmentation. Okay, and we also discussed about the external fragmentation. Abhi external fragmentation kya hota hai? By counting the total remaining space from these partitions, okay, koi ek nayi process hai, and if you cannot allocate that process any partition, but if here in this example we saw 2 MB 1 MB 2 MB 2 MB, this much space was left over in the fixed in this partitions, right? So total there was 6 7 MB were available, and if any process with the 7 MB requirement or less than the 7 MB requirement, we cannot place that process into this memory, isn't it? So even if we have the space, we cannot allocate that, and this is called as the external fragmentation. So this was about the fixed partitioning or a static method. Then we discussed about the dynamic or the dynamic contiguous method, which is also called as the variable contiguous method. So what is happening in this? We are not fixing out the partition size, or we also can say ki yahan pe whatever the memory you have, this will be the entire only block will be available, right? Only one block of memory will be available, from which at the time of system configuration, OS will consume some of the part, some memory, and the leftover space will be kept as it is. Okay, there will not be any partition ki itne size ka, aisa kuch nahi rahega. This entire will be empty. As and when your process will arrive, as and when your process will require any space for the execution, that space will be allocated that process, and there is no any limitation on the size of the process. In the previous type, there is a limitation on the size of the process ki agar partition 5 MB ka hai to your process should be 5 MB or less than 5 MB, but this is not happening in this case. Process size is not limited. Also, we can place number of processes, we can increase the number of processes, we can place number of processes into this method. So multi programming, degree of multi programming will also be increased. Okay, so this is a very important part of the memory management. This questions will be asked in the Viva examination 101%, so that is why I have repeated one more time. So let us now start with the next part, that is the contiguous memory allocation strategies. Contiguous memory allocation strategies, I mean, if we have, even if we have the partition, fixed type of partitions, now that partitions, if the size is variable, jo second type humne dekha tha ki partitions ke static mein ka second diagram jo humne dekha tha ki partitions ke jo sizes hai, if they are variable, okay, and if number of processes will request for the memory if they want to place, then how we are going to allocate those processes, matlab kon se partition mein hum kon sa process rakhenge, that we have to discuss now. Okay, remember, if you have the blocks of the processes, I mean the thread of the processes, those thread should be placed in the continuous manner only. Okay, you cannot span the process, you cannot divide the process in the contiguous memory allocation. This is the very important point. Okay, contiguous memory allocation mein aisa nahi ki 5 MB mere paas upar 2 MB baki hai, niche 3 MB baki hai, so I will divide the process and I will upload there. Okay, no, it is not happening in the contiguous memory allocation. The entire process you have to place if you have place, if you have that much of address space, otherwise you cannot move that process to the RAM. Okay, fine. So is it visible?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So memory allocation strategies. If processes request the free hole, the whatever leftover space hai ya fir jo bhi aapke partitions hai, if the process requests the free hole, then question is which free hole should be allocated to this process. Okay, so to decide that which process or by using which method we can use, we can allocate the process into that particular partition, how we are going to decide? By using this four, this is actually three hi consider kiye jate hain, first fit, best fit and the worst fit. This is somehow hum keh sakte hain ki iska ek extension hai, first fit ka next fit ye ek extension hai. So these are the strategies which are used to allocate the free hole to the requesting processes. Okay, the first one is the first fit. Simple method hai, naam se hi aapko pata chal raha hai. First fit means we will allocate the first hole that is big enough, okay, we will allocate the first hole that is big enough, which will fulfill the requirement of your requesting process. Okay, this is the first fit. मतलब मान लो आपके पास कोई ऐसा मेमोरी ब्लॉक है. दिस इज द मेमोरी ब्लॉक इफ यू हैव एंड सम पार्टीशंस और सम होल्स आर अवेलेबल हियर एंड इफ एनी प्रोसेस इज रिक्वेस्टिंग फॉर सम 5 MB और 10 MB और 500 MB वॉट एवर द स्पेस विच इज रिक्वायर्ड बाय दिस P1 प्रोसेस अगर सेटिस्फाई करने वाला वो रिक्वायरमेंट फुलफिल करने वाला पार्टीशन जो भी सबसे पहले आपको मिले while in the searching, that partition will be allocated to that process. It doesn't matter ki kitna internal fragmentation ho raha hai ya fir kitna space waste ho raha hai, we are not looking for that. Okay, the thing is that we are simply allocating the free or the first enough memory which will fulfill the requirement of the requesting process. That is the first fit. Okay, now remember, if any another process will arrive, अभी मान लो P1 को यहाँ पे मैंने प्लेस किया इस फर्स्ट ब्लॉक में, और P2 आया, so P2 for checking out the requirement completion of P2, your process will start searching of the hole or the searching of the partition or the block from the very initial address. Okay, जो भी first location है आपका memory का, इवन इफ यू नो कि आपने लास्ट अटेम्प्ट में उसको यहाँ से मतलब ये वाला अलोकेट कर दिया है, सो यू कैन नॉट फुल यू कैन नॉट प्लेस दिस P2 हियर, वी नो दैट, बट स्टिल योर प्रोसेस विल सर्च फ्रॉम हियर द फर्स्ट एड्रेस, वहाँ से फिर से सर्चिंग होगा, फिर जो भी उसको पहला अवेलेबल, मान लो इसका 300 MB है और इसका 400 MB है इधर, और P2 रिक्वायर्स 315 MB. ओके, सो यहाँ से सर्च स्टार्ट होके अभी वी हैव अ स्पेस, वी हैव एम्प्टी होल ऑफ 300 MB, बट वी कैन नॉट फुलफिल द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ P2 हियर, सो वी विल सर्च फॉर द नेक्स्ट होल, सो हियर इज अ 400 MB विच विल फुलफिल द P2, सो P2 विल बी प्लेस्ड हियर द फर्स्ट विच इज, अभी मान लो इसके नेक्स्ट वाला 350 है, तो यहाँ प्लेस करते तो ज्यादा बेहतर रहता ना, कम इंटरनल फ्रेगमेंटेशन होता, बट स्टिल जो भी फर्स्ट आपको इनफ मेमोरी मिलेगा, वी आर गोइंग टू प्लेस दैट प्रोसेस इनटू दैट ब्लॉक. ओके, दैट इज द फर्स्ट फीट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज द नेक्स्ट फीट, इट वर्क्स सेम एज अ फर्स्ट बीट. ओके, द चेंज और द डिफरेंस इज दैट, ओनली द डिफरेंस इज दैट यूअर सर्च will begin from the last allocated hole. इसमें जो मैंने एक बताया ना कि even if you have allocated here and you know that यहाँ तक तो अभी जगह है ही नहीं, so you should start from here. This is not happening in the first fit. That is happening in the next fit. Okay, next fit में ये possibility है कि if you have allocated and for that purpose one counter यहाँ पे एक जो है काउंटर, या आप ये कह सकते हैं कि इसको यहाँ पे पॉइंटर लगाया जाता है, नॉट काउंटर, हियर वन पॉइंटर विल बी अवेलेबल वेयर वी हैव लास्ट प्रोसेस अलोकेटेड. ओके, सो फ्रॉम हियर ऑनवर्ड्स फॉर द नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस रिक्वायरमेंट फुलफिलमेंट द सर्च विल बिगिन, सर्चिंग विल बिगिन. ओके, दैट इज द नेक्स्ट फीट. दिस वर्क्स सेम एज अ फर्स्ट फीट, but start search always from the last allocated hole. ठीक है, तो इस केस में अगर मान लो P2 यहाँ नहीं है, इस केस में अगर P1 यहाँ पे है और यहाँ से सब खाली है, then it will start from here. अगर ये वाला example लेते हैं, P2 हमने last allocate किया था, मान लो किसी इसमें P2 हमने last allocate किया था यहाँ पे, and if again P3 will arrive, so search will start from here. Even if you have the leftover space here, but search will start from the last allocated hole. Okay, this is the next fit. Now best fit, in this best fit we allocate the smallest hole that is big enough. Okay, we will allocate the partition or the memory to the requesting processes which is big enough, and for that purpose your process have to or we can say your processor have to search the entire memory location. See, okay, first I will explain this. Your for the best fit, if any process will request, मान लो अभी P1 process है इस block के लिए, who is requesting for 200 MB. यहाँ पे this is the block of 150, this is 300, consider this is 250 and this one is 50. Okay, so I'm saying if P1 is requesting for 200 MB and we are applying the best fit strategy, then your processor will search the entire memory and it will compare the available memory and the request of the process. So 200 MB kis mein hum yahan pe kis partition mein allocate karenge, so that the internal fragmentation ya fir jo bhi iska size bachne wala hai, space bachne wala hai, that should be less. Wahan pe internal fragmentation should be less. Ye hum consider karke best fit apply karte hain. So in this case P1 is requesting for the 200 MB and we have the partition of 150, yahan to possible hi nahi hai. 300, yes it is possible, but if you allocate 200 here, the 100 MB internal fragmentation will be there. Okay, या हम कह सकते हैं कि उतना 100 MB बचेगा. Now next is the 250. यहाँ पे allocate करते हैं तो 50 बचेगा. यहाँ पे है 50 MB. So we cannot fulfill the requirement of P1 in this last partition. So from this both we have to compare and we will allocate the P1 process to 250 partition. क्योंकि यहाँ पे कम internal fragmentation, so we'll allocate here. So this is the working of the best fit allocation, but internal fragmentation, the main thing here is internal fragmentation. This IF is internal fragmentation will be less, okay? But due to the requirement of searching of entire memory location, यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है, पूरा memory location हम लोग वापस वापस search कर रहे हैं ना, पूरा उसको compare करने के लिए. So this वहाँ पे उस time पे this process becomes slow. तो ये method क्या है, as compared to first fit slow बन जाता है, okay? Now the last one is the worst fit. In this worst fit, we allocate the largest hole. Okay. Now suppose here is my block. This is my block. Here I have 200 MB, 500 MB, and 700 MB. Huh? And if P1 arrives with the request of 70 MB. If the P1 process comes with the request of 70 MB. So if we are applying the worst fit strategy, then from this, your processor will search for the largest hole available, the largest partition which is available. So it will search here 200, 500, 700, and then it will compare. And after comparing, it find out that 700 MB is the largest hole. So this 70 MB will be allocated here. Okay, this 70 MB will be allocated here. But once you allocate, now here, इस केस में अभी ऐसा है, when we are, we can say, एक प्रोसेस यहाँ पे ये कर, ये दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ, ये जो भी हम स्ट्रेटेजीज देख रहे हैं, दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ डायनामिक कंटिजुअस मेमोरी एलोकेशन. डायनामिक कंटिजुअस मेमोरी एलोकेशन, ओके. सो इन दिस केस इट इज अलाउड कि आप अगर यहाँ पे 70 MB allocate करते हैं, then in the leftover space you can allocate the remaining processes if they request for, मान लो यहाँ पे 50 MB का फिर से request आया, second process के लिए 50 MB request आया, then it will compare the remaining all the partitions 200 MB, 500 MB, and from this 770 का हमने पहले apply किया था, तो यहाँ पे 630 will be available, right? यहाँ पे 630 MB is leftover, so this is the largest hole which is available now. So that requesting P2 process will be allocated in this leftover space. Okay. So these are all the strategies to allocate the processes into the dynamic contiguous memory allocation. Now by using this method, the numericals will be asked for 10 marks. आपके ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन 1 मार्क्स 2 मार्क्स के भी आते हैं इस पे, और यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जामिनेशन में 10 मार्क्स का क्वेश्चन होता है. सो वील सी वन वन और टू एग्जाम्पल्स बेस्ड अपॉन दिस. ओके द क्वेश्चन इज द रिक्वेस्ट फ्रॉम प्रोसेसेस आर 300K, 25K, 125K, 50K रिस्पेक्टिवली. द अबाउ रिक्वेस्ट कुड बी सेटिस्फाइड विथ. द ऑप्शंस गिवन आर बेस्ट फिट बट नॉट फर्स्ट फिट, फर्स्ट फिट बट नॉट बेस्ट फिट, थर्ड ऑप्शन इज बोथ एंड लास्ट इज द नन. ओके दिस इज द गिवन ब्लॉक ऑफ मेमरी एंड वी हैव टू एनालाइज इट by using the best fit, by using the first fit, दोनों भी सेम ही हैं, तो दो ही मेथड अप्लाई करके हमें चेक करना है. सो दिस इज द गिवन ब्लॉक. सो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस फर्स्ट. दिस इज ऑलरेडी अलोकेटेड, ये स्पेस अवेलेबल नहीं है. हियर इज वी हैव 150 KB. Now again here is allocated space and somewhere here is allocated. This is 350 KB. Now what is asked? There is a requirement of 300K, 25K, 125K and the 50K. And first we will start with the best fit. ठीक है, हम पहले best fit से स्टार्ट करते हैं. सो बेस्ट फिट, व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी विल अलोकेट द स्मॉलेस्ट होल दैट इज बिग इनफ. वी विल अलोकेट द स्मॉलेस्ट होल दैट इज बिग इनफ, राइट. सो नाउ चेक आउट द रिक्वायरमेंट. द रिक्वायरमेंट इज 300K. द फर्स्ट प्रोसेस रिक्वायरमेंट इज 300K. सो वी विल सर्च फ्रॉम हियर, वी विल बिगिन द सर्च फ्रॉम हियर. दिस इज 150 KB. Here is 350 KB, so we cannot fulfill here, so we can fulfill here 300 KB. So I will allocate here. This is 300 KB humne allocate kiya, and the leftover space then will be 50 KB, right? 50 KB will be remaining. Now the next one, 25K. हमें ऐसा चेक करना है जहां पे इंटरनल फ्रेगमेंटेशन शुड बी लेस. 25K. So if I will put 25K here, then what will happen? बहुत सारा leftover space. Then again, here we have 50K का hole. So we can compare कि ज़्यादा कम किस में रह रहा है, तो यहाँ पे. So we will allocate the leftover here. यहाँ पे मैंने क्या किया, 25K allocate कर दिया. The remaining will be again 25K. Fine. Now the next is 125K. दो ही पार्टीशन बचे हैं, 150 एंड हियर इज 25K. सो वी हैव टू पुट दिस 125K हियर. सो आई विल पुट दिस हियर 125K. नाउ 125 मतलब बचा कितना, 25K. Now the next request is 50K. Here we have 25K. Here we have the leftover hole 25K. Total 50K is available. But this is the one process which requires the 50K. And we know that in the contiguous memory allocation, we cannot spam. We cannot span. We cannot divide this process into the different parts. सो ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि 25 यहाँ पे 25 यहाँ पे अलोकेट करे. सो वी कैन नॉट प्लेस दिस लास्ट प्रोसेस इन टू द मेमरी फॉर नाउ. ओके सो कांट प्लेस लास्ट प्रोसेस इन द बेस्ट फिट. ओके वी वेर टॉकिंग अबाउट द बेस्ट फिट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट मेथड वी हैव टू चेक फॉर फर्स्ट फिट. नाउ हियर आई विल ड्रॉ. ओके द फर्स्ट रिक्वायरमेंट इज 325, 125 एंड द 50. सो आई विल स्टार्ट विद द 300. नाउ दिस इज द फर्स्ट फीट. फर्स्ट फीट से अप्लाई कर रहे हैं हम लोग यहाँ पे. फर्स्ट फिट क्या होता है? जो भी पहला ब्लॉक मिले विच विल फुलफिल द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ यूर प्रोसेस, वी विल अलोकेट दैट प्रोसेस इन टू दैट पार्टीशन. दैट इज फर्स्ट फिट, इजंट इट? सो फर्स्ट रिक्वायरमेंट इज 300K. सो वी कैन नॉट प्लेस हियर बिकॉज वी हैव 150K अवेलेबल. सो वी कैन नॉट फुलफिल. सो विल गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट होल, दैट इज 350. सो येस, आई कैन प्लेस 300K प्रोसेस हियर. 300K का प्रोसेस मैंने इधर अप्लाई किया, देन रिमेनिंग विल बी 50K. नाउ द नेक्स्ट रिक्वायरमेंट इज 25K. अगेन दिस इज द फर्स्ट फीट, सो इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग. सर्चिंग शुरुआत से स्टार्ट करेगा. सो 25K, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट अवेलेबल होल, दैट इज 150K. वी कैन प्लेस हियर 25K. सो आई विल पुट समवेयर हियर 25K प्रोसेस. So the leftover will be 125K. Now the next requirement is 125. So your processor will start searching from the initial allocation, right? यहाँ पे address space जहाँ पे start हो रहा है वहाँ से ही हम शुरू करेंगे searching. So requirement is 125. Available block is also 125. So we can allocate this process in the first available hole. 125K हमने यहाँ पे अलोकेट कर दिया, ठीक है. नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन रिमेनिंग इज 50. सो हियर वी हैव सर्चिंग विल बिगिन फ्रॉम द इनिशियल स्टेट एंड देन इट विल सर्च सर्च सर्च. हियर इज अवेलेबल होल विच इज ऑफ 50K. रिक्वायरमेंट इज 50K. सो वी कैन से वी विल अलोकेट द 50K प्रोसेस समवेयर हियर 50K, राइट? So by using the first feed, we have allocated all the processes, right? Every process has placed into the RAM. सबको जगह मिल गया है वहाँ पे. And best feed में एक process was not placed. So we can say here, option A क्या है? Best feed, but not. Question was the above request could be satisfied with best feed, but not first feed. Best feed से तो हमारा हुआ ही नहीं था satisfy पूरा. Right, so this option is wrong. First feed but not best feed, both and none. So your option B is correct. First feed but not best feed. Clear hai? The question is clear. Okay. So let me. This is this type of the question will be asked for objective questions. 2 marks ke liye MCQ ya fir aapka UT jo hoga usme bhi hoga. Not for this UT. Fourth unit will be there for your. UT second. Okay. Now this type of the question will be asked for end sem examination for 10 marks. The question given is, given memory partition of 100K, 500K, 200K, 300K, 600K in order. How would each of the first feet, best feet, worst feet algorithms place the processes of 212K, 417K, 112K, and 426K in order? Which algorithm makes the most efficient use of the memory? The question is, which algorithm makes the most efficient use of memory? मतलब हमें ये देखना होगा कि सारे के सारे processes किसमें आ रहे हैं. We can place in which method all the processes, and if सारे के सारे processes अगर सारे method से भी हो रहे हैं, then in which we have the less internal fragmentation. Okay,
ma'am, screen is blurred.
I'm checking out, just a minute. Okay, so we have the given partition sizes. So I will start with the first, that is first feed. This question will be asked for 10 marks in your end sem exam. First feed. partition available is 100K. The next is 500K, 200, 300, 600. Okay. So the requirement is 212, 417, 112, 426. So first feat hai, matlab searching will begin from the initial address space in every state, every time. So 212. So 212 first available, 500K ka partition hai yahan pe. So we can say here 212 mein I can place here 212. So 500 minus 212 kitna aa raha hai batao fatafat. 500 minus 212
288.
Yes, 288. Then the next is 417. Start searching from here. 417 here we can place 417. Right, 600 minus 417, 183. Leftover is 183. This done. 112. Again, start from the beginning. 112. We cannot place here. 288 ka block hai yahan pe. So I can place 112 here. So 288 minus 112. Remaining will be 176. 176 अभी भी बचा हुआ है यहाँ पे. The next, this is done. 426. Start searching from the beginning. 426. Can we place anywhere 426? By using this first fit method, can we place anywhere 426? We don't have any block available which is enough to place this process, 426 process. Even if by combining everything, 100K hai yahan pe, 126, 200, 300, itna sara space hai. But still we cannot allocate this 426 because we cannot span, we cannot divide, can't divide the process in contiguous memory allocation. So here by using the first fit method, 426 ke requirement not fulfilled. Okay, this is the first feat. Now next is best feat. Hundred K, 500K, 200K, 300K, 100, 500, 200, 300, and 600K. Okay. And our requirement of the processes is 212, 417, 112, and 426. Okay. Best feat hai. What happens in best feat? Which is the least partition or the less available memory hole is available, which will fulfill the requirement of our process that we have to search, right? So we will start from the beginning. 100, first requirement is 212. So 100 yahan pe to nahi, 500 ke yahan pe ho sakta hai, right? But 500 yahan pe 212 kiya to kitna leftover rahega? वो कंपेयर करेंगे बाकी केस से. जैसे यहाँ पे 200 है, यहाँ पे 300 है, दिस इज द 600. सो एवरीथिंग विल बी कंपेयर्ड. सो जहाँ पे कम लेफ्ट ओवर स्पेस बच जाएगा उस वाले पार्टीशन में वी विल अलोकेट दिस प्रोसेस. सो 212 वी कैन से इन दिस 300 होल वी कैन प्लेस दिस 212 रिक्वायरमेंट, राइट? सो 300 माइनस 212 ही है ना. हाँ, 300 माइनस 212 कितना बचा?
88.
Yes, 88 is leftover space. 417. Again, it will start from the beginning. It will start from the beginning. That is why this best fit, while we are actually implementing, this is the slow process as compared to the first fit. Best fit में क्या होता है कि entire searching होता है, फिर comparison होता है, and then we allocate. Okay, the next is 417. Okay, we can allocate here. Also, we can allocate here. And 417, if we will put here, then there will be less fragmentation. Here will be the less internal more internal fragmentation. So we will put this 417 here. So 500 minus 417, 83 left over space. Okay, the next is 112, 200 hai, 88 and 600. So we'll put 112 here. 200 minus 112. Again, 88 left over space. This is done. 426, start from the beginning. 426, this is the 100 block, so we cannot place 83, 88, 88, 600. Here we can place 426, right? 426. The leftover space will be 600 minus
174.
So we have placed all the processes into this memory block, and still we have some remaining place. Hamara sare requirement fulfill ho chuka hai. So this is fulfilling all the processes. Now we have to check for worst fit also. Worst fit mein kya karte hain? Jo largest block milega, jo sabse largest hoga, we will allocate that block to that requesting process. Okay, 100, 500, 200, 300, 600. Requirement is 212, 417, 112, and 426. Fine. The first is requirement of 212. In the worst fit, the largest hole which will be available, or the largest partition which is available into entire memory, that we will allocate to the requesting process. So 212 hai. This is also, again, it is a slow, because largest hole search karne ke liye hum pura memory space search mar rahe hai na, fir usko compare bhi kar rahe hai. Isliye, this is also slow as compared to the first fit. Okay, now 212 ke liye sabse pehle to hum largest hole dhundenge, to yahan pe hai. So we will allocate here 212. 600 minus 212. 600 minus 212. Kitna aega?
388.
388, right? 388. Okay, 212 is done. Next, 417. Search for the largest block. 417. Sirf yahan pe fulfill ho sakta hai. So we'll allocate 417 here. 500 minus 417. 83. This is done. Now next, 112 can't place. 112 can't. Okay, yahan pe kar sakte hain. 300 maybe we also can place, and 388. This is the worst fit. That means we have to check for the largest hole. This is the largest hole, 388, right? So I will put this 112 in this block. So 388 minus 112. 276. This is done. Now 426, largest block we have to search. 426, this is 183, 200, 300, this is 276. So there is no any space available for 426, so we cannot fulfill this requirement, right? So 426 requirement not fulfilled in worst fit method. Okay, so worst fit mein nahi hua, first fit mein bhi nahi hua, only one is there, that is the best fit, which is fulfilling all the requirement. So we can say the question asked was, which algorithm makes the most efficient use of memory? So at the end you have to write, best fit makes the most efficient यूज ऑफ मेमोरी. दिस शुड बी योर आंसर. हाँ, ऐसे ही सिर्फ सॉल्व करके छोड़ मत देना, फिर वहां पे 10 मार्क्स के बजाय आपको 9 मार्क्स मिलेंगे. यू हैव टू कंक्लूड योर आंसर. बेस्ट ऑफ इट मेक्स द मोस्ट इफिशियंट यूज ऑफ मेमोरी इन दिस सिचुएशन. क्लियर है? इज इट क्लियर? सिंपल है फॉर 10 मार्क्स?
यस.
ओके, सो राइट डाउन दिस क्वेश्चन एंड यू हैव टू सॉल्व दिस एंड लेट मी नो द आंसर. नाउ द क्वेश्चन हियर इज गिवन मेमोरी पार्टीशन ऑफ, राइट डाउन दिस क्वेश्चन, गिवन मेमोरी पार्टीशन ऑफ 150 KB, 550 KB, 250 KB एंड 350 KB, वन मोर 650 KB. हाउ वुड ईच ऑफ द फर्स्ट फीट, बेस्ट फीट, वर्स्ट फीट एल्गोरिदम्स प्लेस प्रोसेसेस 220K, 420K, 120K, 430K इन ऑर्डर? विच एल्गोरिदम मेक्स द वर्स्ट यूज ऑफ मेमोरी? You have to read your question very carefully. The previous question was asking for the best use of memory, and this question is asking for the worst use of memory. So whenever you are reading the question, read it carefully. वरना आप जो भी conclude करोगे, that will become wrong answer. आप भले ही solve तो एक जैसा ही करोगे, दोनों case में आपको सब कुछ solve करना ही पड़ेगा. But at the end, whatever you are writing the conclusion, that should match the requirement or the question answer. Okay? So write down this question. Given memory partition, you have to solve this for first fit, best fit, and the worst fit. And let me know the answer, which algorithm will make the worst use of memory.